السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear students, we have just concluded in the past lesson the letters of the Arabic language. Today in this session, I want to take a journey to visit each letter before we continue on to our further lessons. We're going to visit each letter in their homes. So we're going to cover the addresses of the letters, where each letter lives, and we're going to visit that letter and see how exactly the letter is pronounced, the articulation, the sound, in detail. So before we move on, you will be upon clear insight as to the sound of each letter. Now, before we start with visiting the letters, I would like to inform you that there are some main articulations, main addresses where letters come from. We have number one, it's something called the throat. The throat, of course, is what follows after the tongue up until the vocals, where the vocals begin. Now, the throat has an upper part, it has the middle part, and it has the lower part. We will cover that, inshallah. So, this is one of the main articulations where the letters come from. The second is the tongue. Now, surprisingly, most letters come from the tongue. We have the back of the tongue, we have the middle of the tongue, we have the frontal of the tongue, we have the sides of the tongue, we have the tip of the tongue. And three, we have the lips. We also use the lips to pronounce certain letters. And of course, all of these main, there are certain parts of your mouth that assist. So assistants, I would not, they're not considered to be the main articulations, but they assist. For example, the palate, right? In the palate, we have the hard palate, we have the frontal palate, the roof, we have the middle palate, the hard palate, and we have the back, soft palate, right? Although in the back, we're talking about the roof of the mouth. So palate is the roof that assists in pronouncing the letters. What else assists in pronouncing the letters? We also have the teeth. The teeth, they also help pronouncing the letters. And of course, we have other parts which we don't need to mention. But these are the main articulations where the letters do come from, and we're going to cover them one by one now. Let us begin with the throat. Actually, I'm going to take you through a journey in a very systematic manner. How? We are going to begin from the throat, from right on the bottom of the throat. We're going to come up. As we come up, as you can see, the throat, we're going to come up. As we come up, right, we're going to come to the tongue, the back of the tongue, we're going to come in the front, and then we're going to end up with the lips, okay? And then we're going to go back to show you both ways how the letters come. Let us begin this journey. So, first of all, we want to be on clear insight. So we have, for example, number one, we have, so these are the addresses. The addresses of the letters. Beginning with the throat, we have number one, we're going to number the letters. We have Hamza. Now Hamza, the sound is ah. Now in this session, I want you to feel the sounds. Feel the sounds. Beginning from all the way down. That's where the vocal cords begin. Very cutting sound. Right? And then we have number two. Ha. We have the letter ha. 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 That's also where the vocals begin. Ha. 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 Okay? Now that's the bottom of the throat. Right? This is what? The bottom. Bottom of throat. Okay? Now, next one, letter number three, is Ayn. 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 You can say, see in the middle of the throat, Ayn. 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 Feel the sound. Ayn. Okay, the middle of the throat. And letter number four, we have ha. 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 You feel it in the middle of the throat. Ha, ha, ha. Okay. Now this come from where? This come from the middle of throat. Okay. Then we have letter number five. We're going to now top of the throat. Ghain. Ghain. The wet part of the upper throat. That's where you gargle from. Ghain. Ghain.
And number six.
Kha. It's top part of the throat, but it's a dry part of the throat. Kha. Ha, ha.
So this is what? The top of throat. Alright.
So we have the bottom of the throat, we have the middle of the throat, we have the top part of the throat.
Now this one, it is the throat.
So we covered up until now the throat, alhamdulillah.
So this one, let's mark that. Okay.
Let's move on to the next part. We have covered the six letters. Next part again, now going to the back of the tongue. Again, we're coming up. Okay, we just came up. We're in the back of the tongue now.
We have letter number seven.
We have the cough, 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 cough. Now, where does the cough come from?
It is back of tongue, right? With what? The soft palate.
Back of the tongue with soft palate. The soft. The back of the tongue touches the soft palate up.
Next letter, we have number eight. Calf.
Ka 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 ka. That is what. Again, we're coming out, right? So, cough all the way back, and then you come a little further more out. You have the calf, right? Which also is back of tongue. But this is what? This is soft, right? The soft and hard palate. How? There's a soft and the hard palate. If you realize where the soft palate ends and the hard palate begins, that's where the calf, the tongue touches that part. Okay? Let's move on. Letter number 9. After you finish the back of the tongue, you come to the middle of the tongue. This is where j you see the middle of the tongue? You feel a bit ticklish when you say this sound. J. The middle of the tongue, it touches the middle of the hard palate, right? Jim. And next we have sheen. It's also the middle of the tongue, but if you realize the jim, the middle of the tongue, touches the hard palate, right? With strength. And then sheen, it's not exactly touching the hard palate, but it's letting a little space so the wind can pass. Right? And then you have yeah. This is also the middle of the tongue, but if you realize, compared to jim and sheen, yeah is the softest. It's allowing more space between the middle of the tongue and the roof to let the wind pass, and it is much softer. So, conclusion. Jim, we say middle of tongue, middle of the tongue, but we're gonna say it is strong. Middle of the tongue, but it touches the roof sharply with strength. As for the sheen, you have also middle of the tongue, right? But it is medium strength, right? It is like medium, it's soft, but it's not that soft, like yeah, but medium. What do you mean medium? Meaning the middle of the tongue touching the roof is not touching too strongly, but it's letting a little space. And the yeah is also middle of tongue, but this is very light. Instead of light, we're gonna say soft. Soft. Yeah. So again, look. Jim. J. See? Strong. And then sh. Right? Medium. And then yeah. Yeah. It is soft. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 letters covered. We are going to cover all 29 letters. So let's move on. Okay, now this one is number 12. We'll finish with the middle of the tongue. Now we're going where? Let's go to the side of the tongue before we come to the front. The size of the tongue. We have dod. Now dod. It actually comes from the sides of the tongue. You can use one side, the left side, for example. But you see, your jaw, the tongue, the left side of the tongue, for example, is easier, for me at least, to touch the inside part of the gums. So, for example, these are your gums, right? These are my gums, okay? Here. These are my gums. And this is my tongue. It touches the inside part of my gums. It presses against my gums, right? And the tongue should not touch the back of the teeth, because that's where dal comes from, but it should actually remain where the lam comes from. Lam, where the palate begins, the gums begin, the tongue should remain there, the frontal part of the tongue. And you basically look, you come from the back like this, like that. So this is the tongue, right? The side of the palate inside. If you begin from the side of the tongue, come to the front. Come to the front. Look. Blood, 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 blood. It's a very strong letter. Okay? So this is the side. Side of the tongue. Side of the tongue. But this is what the full side, right? Full side. Why am I saying full side? Because letter number 13, which is lam, 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 comes from the frontal side. Look. Yeah. Yeah. Frontal sides, which touch the top. So this is also sides of tongue, but what? Frontal. Frontal sides of the tongue. Lam, la 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 lam. Okay, keep your tongue soft when you say that. Don't make it tough. Look, lam, la 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 lam. Okay, letter number 14. So we're done with the sides of the tongue. So we have here the sides. We have here, let's mark it. Back, middle, sides. Okay, there's the back, middle, sides. Okay, what's next? We have also letter number 14. Let's come to the frontal part of the tongue, the front of the tongue. We have, first we're going to take the front of the tongue, right, to the top. Let's go to the roof, and after the roof, we're going to come behind the upper teeth, and then we'll come behind the bottom teeth, okay? So we have, for example, on the roof, we have na 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 noon na 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 noon, right? And ra 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 noon. Letter number 15. Ra. Where these both come from? Where? They both come from the front tongue. Both of them come from the frontal part of the tongue. Roof. Or we're going to say with the front palate. With the front palate. Na 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 noon and ra ra ra. Front palate, noon or ra. Alright, so we have here. Front. Front part of the tongue. Okay. Then let us switch. Okay. So we have more space. So we have the frontal part of the tongue and the roof. Now come behind the upper teeth. We have letter number 15 and now 16. So letter number 16. We have ta, 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 He behind the upper teeth, the front part of the tongue behind the upper teeth. Right behind the upper teeth. And then we have dal, dal behind the upper teeth. Pa, 17, dal. And then we have ta 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 ta. Same place. Ta. So this come from where? They come from front tongue. Right, with what? Behind upper teeth. So this is what? Front of the tongue. You also have the front of the tongue here, but you know, you have to differentiate what we mean by front. This is front part of the tongue with the front palate, right? And this is the front of the tongue with the teeth, the upper teeth. Now we finish the upper teeth, let's come to the bottom teeth. Number 19, the bottom teeth, we have right, we have the letter S. His tongue resting behind that bottom teeth. Sod. The tongue should be resting on the bottom behind the upper bottom teeth. Sod. And we have number 20. We have the letter za, za. Same place, za. And then we have the letter 21. The letter seen. Seen. These four come from where? Okay, we're gonna say front tongue behind bottom teeth. Behind bottom teeth. So this is also front part of the tongue. Okay. 21 letters are taken care of. Right. How many remain? Let's continue, inshallah. 22. 22. So we had the throat, the bottom of the throat, the middle of the throat, bottom of the throat, middle of the throat, upper part of the throat, back of the tongue, middle of the tongue, sides of the tongue, front of the tongue to the roof, front of the tongue behind upper teeth, front of the tongue behind bottom teeth. Right? What are we left with? we're left with the front part of the tongue now with teeth. We have the letter the. See? The front part of the tongue behind upper teeth. The. So we're coming out, right? You know, we start from the throat, we're coming out. So see? Now we're coming out. The. 23. We have val, val. And then 24 we have fa. So we have va, val, fa. As you can see, the tongue comes out behind beneath the upper teeth. So this one we're gonna say what? Front tongue behind, oh, sorry about that.
under upper teeth. Okay? So this one also front.
All right, 24 letters covered, right? We got 4 more letters that have sounds.
25.
What do we have? 25, we have... Now we're done with the front part of the tongue. What's left? There's nothing left. Actually, you know, the tip of the tongue actually represented by the front part of the tongue. Where noon and ra, so that's like the tip, right? And the frontal part of the tongue. So, tip is really the frontal part of the tongue, right? So, noon and ra here. So, now we have here, we have the tongue now coming out and finished. Now we have the lips. We have, let's still be inside. We have the lips with what? The teeth. The teeth are still inside, so we have fa. See, inner part of the lips, the wet part of the lips. Fa. Fa.
Okay? So this is what, this is inner lips, lip with what? Upper teeth. Okay. All right. These are lips. We have 26.
We have now. Teeth are over. Now we have the lips. Both lips. We have. Letter wow, wow, where you're going to use both lips. Wow, wow, wow. We let the wind out. Wow.
This one. Both lips.
Okay.
27.
We have what? We have the letter ba, ba. See, ba is the inner part of the lips. Just put the lips together. Ba, 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 ba.
Okay. Now this is what the inner lips, or the lips.
We have the. And the out part of the lips, we have the inner, and then we have the actual outer.
What do I mean by that? Look, letter number 28.
We have meme, meme. You see, for ba, b, 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 and then meme. You see, for meme, we have to press harder, so it's using the whole lips. Meme, meme.
You have the meme. Okay, so this is also the lips. So using the outer lips now. Okay. For fa, of course, for wow, both lips, and we have to mention here, no contact.
So. For wow, the lips don't contact each other, right? There's an opening. Wow, wow.
Okay.
Ba and meme,
they have contact. Okay. This also, this is lips.
All right, so 28 letters covered. All the letters, alhamdulillah, they have sounds, have been covered. Right, we have here again. Let's go again. We have hamza ha, ain ha, ghain kha. Right, قاف كاف جيم شين يا ضاد and لام نون and را on the top and we have طا دال تا in the back of the upper teeth صاد زا سين the front part of the tongue behind the bottom teeth ضا ذال ثا the teeth coming out فا واو با and ميم right what's left there's 29 total letters yes we already mentioned that there's one letter that doesn't have a sound that is alif 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 has no sound it's only used for stretch purposes now let us go back right if you begin from here ميم با واو فا ثا ذال ضا سين زا صاد تا دال طا را نون لام ضاد يا شين جيم كاف قاف غي خاء غين حاء عين هاء همزة Now what's the first letter? Hamza. First letter is Hamza. What's the last letter? Then pronounced letter, meme. What does that make? What does mean in Arabic? Mother. Arabic is the mother of all languages. It's the best of all languages. For that reason, Allah chose to send His final, the best word in the Arabic language upon the best man on earth, Muhammad, peace be upon him. Thank you so much, and I hope you this has helped you to recognize the addresses. Alhamdulillah, we visited each letter. Nice to know all of them. And now we're going to actually move on using these letters to enhance our reading. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.